7-Eleven's the place to stop. Just drive right in and come as you are. We'll come out and serve you in your car.
Brain freeze.
So good, it hurts. Slurpee.
Immigration agents today raided nearly 100 7-Eleven stores in 17 states and Washington, D.C. At least 21 suspected undocumented immigrants were arrested. Officials say the sweep was a follow-up to the 2013 arrests of 9 7-Eleven owners and managers for harboring illegal immigrants.
The guy says stuff that nobody would find tolerable if they were applying for a job at 7-Eleven.
Our police and our firemen down in 7-Eleven, down at the World Trade Center, right after it came down. I was down there, and I watched our police and our firemen down in 7-Eleven, and I saw the greatest people I've ever seen in action. I saw the bravest people I've ever seen, including the construction workers, including every person down there. That's what New York values about. The values that make us love this state, despite its problems. We love this state. We know it's going to come back. If I'm president, it's going to come back so fast you won't even believe it. You watch.
And the fact that now you've got people saying, well, we strongly disapprove. We really disagree. We find those comments disgusting. But we're still endorsing them.
Serious charges against 7-Eleven. Dozens of stores, the targets of a federal investigation for bringing undocumented workers into the U.S., forcing them into virtual slavery. ABC's Rebecca Jarvis is on the case, and she joins us now from one of the stores seized by the feds on Long Island. Good morning, Rebecca.
Hi, George. Good morning. And this is one of 14 stores police have seized from franchise owners, now under the management of 7-Eleven Corporation. And this morning, the probe continues to widen.
The accusations of cruelty and mistreatment now span independently owned 7-Eleven stores in 8 states, from Illinois to Florida to New Jersey. So far, 9 owners and managers from Pakistan and the Philippines arrested for running what the feds are calling modern-day plantations.
You all gonna pay for those?
So what are you, some kind of bounty hunter?
I'm a cop. I'm undercover.
Oh, hey, Karen, it's Joyce. Yeah, I'm just checking on Will. Movies?
You just keep your mouth shut, all right? All right, hop in. Come on, get in.
Hey!
Hey! Hey! You hey! You hey! This is a police emergency, all right? I need to commandeer your vehicle.
What?
As long as there's a...
What is your name, sir?
Todd.
Todd?
Yeah.
Todd.
Todd.
Listen to me. That man in there, I know he doesn't look it, but he is one of the most dangerous men in the world. He's murdered many children.
What?
Yeah, he's a true psychopath. I tracked him over 2 state lines.
Hey, what's going on?
Ah, Detective Byers. This is Todd. He's agreed to lend us his vehicle to transport our dangerous criminal.
Oh, yes, he's very dangerous forger.
Child murderer.
Child murderer.
We should really get going.
Hey, how do I get my car back?
You just call the station.
What station?
Ooh, I like the sound of that, John.
Hey, what station?
You're doing the right thing.
food.
She's gonna hate me.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm Bartholomew Lombardi.
Bartholomew?
Bartholomew. What if I say Bart Lombardi?
Bart Lombardi is a man on a mission.
Bart Lombardi. Yeah.
Barty Lombardi. Barty, Barty, Barty.
She's gonna think I'm a dweeb.
Excuse me. Hi, I'm a Bart Lombardi. Yeah, you're my science class, aren't you?
Smurfies, just when you need them, only at 7-Eleven.
This is a video game. I got it working.
My dad taught me about these.
It is wild gunman.
How do you play this thing?
I'll show you, kid. I'm a crack shot at this.
You have to use your hands? That's like a baby's toy.
Baby's toy? Young man, how about you? You want to give it a try?
No, thank you. Hey, Doc, this...
Son! Funny boy!
Doc.
I just told you that even a baby could handle this weapon. Surely you're not afraid to try something that a baby could do.
Hey, I'm not afraid of nothing.
Oh, come on, man. Let's just step up here like a baby. Now, young man, what you do is you just ease that hammer back there and squeeze off around it. No. Right on out there and be real smooth. That's the way you do it.
Listen, can I try that again?
Yeah, go ahead. Hey, just tell me one thing. Where'd you learn to shoot like that?
7-Eleven.
Do you think he learned it from this 7-Eleven? Nope. This is a different movie. This 7-Eleven was on Terminator Salvation. Do you get the message this one is saying? Well, did you guys see any 5-Elevens? We probably won't see any 5-Elevens unless you know how to see Gematria by, you know, tell Gematria by sight. So I'm going to go through that with you here. All the different scenes I showed having to do with 7-Eleven. Why 7-Eleven? Well, it's a time I'm looking at and I think this, you know, this is crazy. There's so much stuff connected to this. And I think you're going to be blown away when you see all this. The things that you just watched for almost 8 minutes and all the messages that were hidden that you couldn't see. This gives you a good example of what's out there when we watch movies, TV, all kinds of stuff. Even political stuff that you saw on the news and, you know, everything. It's all encoded. And I'm going to show you how that is. It's pretty phenomenal. So this is Exalted Lamb 1. And let's go to the first one. So, oh, thank heaven. You know, the reason why for 7-Eleven, or oh, thank heaven, 7-Eleven, the reason why I'm showing this is because I got a vision in the shower from the Lord, and he's been giving me so many downloads. If this is not the time, the final time, then I don't know why he's giving me so many downloads right now. I've gotten so many, more than ever. Excuse me, I got to clear my throat a little bit. I've gotten more than ever. I'm getting some incredible things, and I'm going to do some incredible decodes that I've been doing the last few days. You'll be blown away, I think. So I got this vision, picture while I was in the shower of, oh, thank heaven, it's 7-Eleven. And the Lord just told me that, and then I got this picture of demons or fallen angels, like just going, oh, thank you, that like we, the Christians, the faithful in Christ, the remnant left, and then they were like, oh, they were so happy that we left, and they were just like, oh, thank heaven, and that's what I got. I was kind of blown away. This intense kind of vision and understanding about this. So, and then I was thinking about Trump and him saying 7-Eleven, all of a sudden I went to his words, and you're going to see what he said, and this will prove that, I think this will prove exactly that he knows what he's saying. He knew what he said. He's part of it. He's not anybody's friend except for the enemy and all their minions. And I'm going to show that to you. So, check this out. Oh, thank heaven for 7-Eleven. It just happens to be in simple gematria or English ordinal 241, which is 6-1. 2 plus 4 is 6 plus and is 1. The 61st day of the year this year, only on a leap year, was March 1st. So I'm saying it's a 3-1 code, and 3-1 is the third month to the elites, which is 5-1. So again, that's hidden. But then we, on the other side, we have 7-1. So we have 7-11 and 3-11 both pointing to in the middle of 5-11. And that's what I'm saying. Now look at this, 5-11 as well. So we have, but also this is 6-1. So that's the 61st day of the year. This is a unique number. It's one of those unique numbers out there that does shows many things. This is also 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. And then 2. And 2, and you're going to see this many, many times, 2 is just 1 and 1 compressed. And I've shared that many times in my videos. So 2, 5 is hidden 5-11 or 11-5. So this is 1 and 1 is 2, and then 4 plus 1 is 5. And then look, we have 11-5, 11-5, 1 plus 4 is 5-11. And this is not hiding, 7-11 is not hiding 5-11. I'm going to show you so many examples of where it's really showing what the real date is. So like I said, the elites believe it's 2 months earlier than what we know it to be. Okay, and Trump made that very clear. There's been other quotes here and there, but mostly I go by Trump's quote because he knew something. He mentioned it, and I believe what he said was the exact attack day. It's very possible. So, and again, this is my grand guess, like always, but I think I'm going to bring you a good amount of evidence, and I'm trying to finally tracking down this time frame possibly here. So, okay, 7-11 is on one end, 3-11's on the other end, and they're both pointing to something between them, 5-11. So, like I said, 3-11 represents the third month, the 11th day. The third month, 11th day to the elites is 5-11 or May 11th. But when they say 7-11, like Trump said, 7-11 to us is the seventh month, the 11th day. But to them, it's the fifth month, the 11th day. So again, both sides are codes for the middle one, which is 5-11. And I'm going to show that to you consistently. So we have, oh, thank heaven for 7-11. Another way it's said is, oh, thank heaven, 7-11. So because, you know, you have, oh, thank heaven, and then you have 7-11. Sometimes this is underneath here or whatever, but many times on commercials they would say, oh, thank heaven for 7-11, or oh, thank heaven, 7-11. So, and then right here, I'm going to show you what this means, why these are 94. It's 93 plus 1, and I'm going to show you what that is, why these are 94. Also, George H.W. Bush, when he died, that he was 94. There's a lot to that. And then it's the attack code of 118. It's 93. I'm going to show you why 93 and 94 are super important. And then we have 11, and then 7 plus 7 is 14. 1 plus 4 is 5. So we have 115 here. And then, again, 9 is a throwaway number when you're compressing numbers, or you can use it to see other numbers. If you throw away 9, it's 115. Or again, this is the way you do it, is 1 plus 9 is 10, take away the 0, then it's 115. Same way, just different method, okay? Same thing, different method, okay? So you see here, you see that these things are hidden. You see 511 in both these, several times, in both of these phrases, and they were on TV millions of times when you count how many people watched them and for how many years. How many people have heard that for so long? So you're being programmed this time frame of 511, 115, and you don't even know it. Like you just watched those, the 8 minutes you just watched. Okay. And then there was this clip of this news report from CBS. And I'm going to show this first. So they're talking about the 7-Eleven raids. Look at this person down here. His name is Jeff Glor underneath this. Look at him. His name in Jewish gematria is 774. 7 plus 4 is 11. So we have 7-Eleven. It's crazy. Here, this one will blow your mind. This blew my mind when I'm like, I knew there was something in this, because it sounded like gematria. And then they literally, right here as they are playing this, they say, immigration agents today raided nearly 100 7-Eleven stores. Nearly 100. They said exactly that way. Nearly 100 7-Eleven stores. And that whole phrase in reverse English gematria, so you take English gematria, which is simple gematria times 6, and then you just reverse it, where Z is 6, and then, you know, Y is 12, and then it goes up from there, times everything times 6 from simple gematria, but reverse. And that's 5101, which is 5-11. They don't count the zeros. I mean, that's incredible. Again, this stuff is going to keep coming up. It's like if I were to keep rolling the dice at certain times and say, hey, I'm thinking about 7-Eleven, and I roll the dice, and it was some version of 5-11 every time. I mean, almost every single time, basically. You go, okay, something's going on here. You know something. Or there's something going on with your dice or something. I mean, no one would go, yeah, well, that's a massive, that's a coincidence. That's a coincidence. That's a coincidence. At some point, if I keep doing it like 100 times, and I'm saying, oh, I'm thinking 7-Eleven, and I roll these die and this die, these set of dice, and they roll at 7-Eleven. Let's say you had 11-sided dice. I don't know. And it kept rolling at 5-Eleven, then you'd be like, wait, something's wrong here. This is planned, you know. But that's how it works. So here we go. Next, 7-Eleven raids. Like it posted right here. Again, we have 1-2-1. Now, we're also talking about these numbers also point to not only the numbers I'm talking about. They point for the beginning day. So I'm talking about July 1st to July 11th to July 13th. So it's a 13-day process. And I've shared that many times. It's the Apple Roll and iPad Goat. You look at my previous videos, I'm going to bring out more stuff about this, how these, when the apple roll falls, it's the first, when the apple falls, it's a birth, it's the first day, then it rolls, there's a fourth day and a fifth day, then there's a seventh and eighth day, and then there's an 11th day and 12th day, which is the tsunamis, and then there's a 13th day, which is the final destruction. So it's going to refer to those, mainly the first day and the 11th day is what these are referring to. So the first day, again, is 1-2, it's just 3-1, so 3-1 is also 5-1. So 5-1, this is backwards, okay? Then 6 plus 7 is 1-3, which is 3-1 backwards. And this is another attack day, that's Trumple, he's Mr. 58. And then we also have, guess what? 6 plus 9 is 15, so we have 1-5-1, and that's a version of 5-11. And then if you weren't so sure, the English gematria backwards is 115. So that is literally in 7-Eleven raids, and this whole phrase, and this guy's name is 7-Eleven. It's crazy. Now here we go. Keep going. And then they were talking about they did it, and then after that phrase, they said in 17 states. And look at this. English ordinals, 115. Also, reverse ordinals, 117. And that's equating them together. You have the normal English gematria, and then the reverse is equating these two, that 115 equals 117, because one's just the reverse. What are the chances of that? Impossible. Literally impossible. I mean, it's off the charts impossible, all these things. Especially when you add them all together, it's really crazy. And so what it's saying here is, as well, in 17 states, there's another news thing I'm going to show you where it talks about eight states and nine owners and managers, and I'm gonna get into that, but it's pointing to 17, which is Stinky B.O.'s number in several ways. He's also, remember I mentioned he's Q, and I'm showing that he's Q. Also backwards is 71, which is the 71st day of the year, which is 311. Also, it's, which I didn't realize until more recently, is July 1st. Again, it's the first day. And then we have July 4th, 4th of July, 4th/5th, and we're gonna have a full moon, 4th and 5th, and that's going to be huge, and I'm going to talk about that, and I've already decoded some things with that already, and then we are going all the way to 7-11, 7-12 would be the tsunamis, and then 7-13, the last final destruction day of the United States is what I'm saying, okay? So here we go. So the 17 is not a coincidence. It's going to happen again. So this was a story, again, from Trump basically had ICE and immigration agents, which are known as ICE, but also another term as well, but had them raid the 7-Eleven stores. And this is all a story with all this fake reporting, so they can get this information out there. They can get all these numbers. They can all do all these rituals and all this messaging behind the scenes and predictably program you. And like I'm showing right here, I mean, look at this. It's going to keep going and going. You won't even believe it. Okay, so, and then they said 9 7-Eleven owners and managers. Think about that for a second. 9 7-Eleven? So 9-11. They're saying 9-11. So 9 7-Eleven owners and managers. So they're showing how 9-11 is 7-Eleven because if you take September 11th, September in Latin is really the seventh month. So 9 is really 7. So 9 7-Eleven owners and managers. Plus, it's a phrase, and it is, look, I'm going to prove this many times, how 2 is decompressed or compressed 1 and 1. So again, we have 2 is really 1 and 1, so 117 or 7-Eleven backwards, 7-Eleven backwards. And then in this situation, we have 3-11. 3, 8 plus 3 is 11. And then we have just 3-11 mixed up, okay? So this is an example. So we have 3-11 where they equate 3-11. to 7-Eleven. In 7-Eleven, it shows how it's hidden by using other ciphers. Other ciphers can they can just prove other ciphers. So they can just prove other examples and other methodologies of ciphers. I'm not sure what I was trying to say there. Okay, so anyway, and then if you just spell it out, because basically when they're talking on the television, they're not talking, they're saying the words. So it's 9-7-Eleven owners and managers, and you still have, so right here, let me just show you for example. I'm going to show you how this is important. So we not only have 6 plus 7 is 13, so we have 113, which is 311 backwards. We have 3, 5 plus 6 is 11, 311. And then we have 3, 1 plus 7 plus 3. Again, this is very common for Jewish. I've seen this 1,000 times. For all these Jewish ciphers to be different versions of the same exact number. I've seen it so many times, it's ridiculous. So in this situation, not only is, because it's the same phrase, it's just spelled differently and done differently. These are with numbers, and that's how they've shown it in different times. But this is with letters. And this is how this is all figured out. Can you imagine trying to figure this out? Try to say these messages. And so we're equating 311 to 7-Eleven. And there's the 311 to 7-Eleven, but there's more 311s in this one. Okay, so that's 3. 1 plus 7 plus 3 is 11. Another thing to look at as well is it's also 1 plus 6 is 7, and then another 7. We have 7-7. I'm going to talk about 7-7 here a little while here. We also have 3. 1 plus 8 is 9. 3-9. Which is 93 backwards, and I'm going to really talk about what the significance of that is. 93, they love 93. They want to go from 9 to 3, the bottom of the pyramid to the top of the pyramid. So there's so much going on with that, so I'm going to show that more. But this all coordinates so incredibly, and it's impossible for this all to work out. And then here's Trumple Thin Skin. And so this is a reporter basically writing this down back when it happened. During a campaign rally earlier this week in Buffalo, Trump said, "It's very close to my heart because I was down there. I watched our police and our firemen down at 7-Eleven, down at the World Trade Center, right after it came down." Now, and then he said more stuff. Of course, it's a rally and everything, right? Well, and you know, and all these different, you know, outlets said, "Oh, he just made a huge mistake. It was a huge gaffe," and everything. And then even his campaign said, "Oh no, he was talking about, you know, the firehouse, 7 this, 1 that, 1 that," or whatever, and he meant down there, or whatever, and then they went back and forth, and then some Snopes in different places said there's no such place, and everything. Anyway, it doesn't matter. It was a code. It was a code of 7-Eleven. First reason for that code, I believe, was to show you that, to them, 9-11 is really 7-Eleven. So September is really the 7th month to them, and to us, the masses, they've given it as the 7th of the 9th month. And then I believe now, as I've understood from what I've been getting from the Lord, Jesus, is that 7-Eleven is really to them, or to us, the, you know, 7th month, but he's referring to 5-Eleven. And I'm going to prove that over and over and over again in the rest of this video. Excuse me. Okay, so look at this. It's very close to my heart. See, I'm going to also prove, this is proving that what Trumple Thin Skin says and who he really is, and that this could not have been just made up. I mean, this couldn't have been organic. You just said it. This is all pre-planned. It shows you, I've caught him many times with pre-planned statements, all kinds of statements that have been completely evil, and pre-planned statements with gematria and everything many times. And if you actually study him and study the things he says at different times, you'll see it too. But most people don't, and they have no clue. So it's very close to my heart. It's the first phrase he said. And because it's natural transition, it's like, you know, like you should put a comma there. It's very close to my heart, comma, because I was down there. Okay, so I did that first. And then look here, an English ordinal, it is, what's that? Okay, it's 2 plus 9 is 11, so we have 11-7. And again, these are proven by other ciphers. 11-7, 11-7. And again, this is proven by that 2 is really decompressed or compressed 1 and 1. So that's 7-11, that's 7-11, that's 7-11, that's 7-11. Look at this. This is also 8 plus 2 is 10. Take away the 0, you have 171, which is a little bit scrambled 7-11. It's crazy. And then we have 1 plus 6 is 7. And then we have 2 again, which is 1 and 1 combined. Or, compressed. I always forget that word compressed for some reason. Because that's the term that they use. So that's 7-2. So the 7-11. So every one of these is some version of 7-11. It's very close to my heart. Can you believe it? I mean, this is absolutely off the charts impossible. This is a massive boom to show you that what's going on. Now there's more. It keeps going. Because I was down there. Okay, again, we are referring to 3-1, which is the first day. The third month at least is really 5. So we're going back to the original, which is really 5-1 to 5-11. And that's their 5-1 to 5-11, which is our 7-1 through 7-11 is what I'm saying. Now, it took me a while to get this down, but, you know, once you get this, when I get this code down, understand all the things they're doing, it makes sense. And then we have, of course, 311 backwards. And then, of course, again, this confirms this as well, that this is 3-1, which is really the third month, which is really May. So it would be, in a sense, 5-1. 122nd day of the year, only on a leap year, is 5-1, May 1st. And then we have 1-2-2 backwards. So this is just backwards, but that's 5-1. And then we have 1-3-2, the 132nd day of the year, only on leap year, is 5-11. And then we have, what do we have here? We have, yeah, what was I saying? What did I say about this guy? Not really sure what I was going to say about this. Maybe this was just, no, I'm not sure. I might just have that there on accident. But anyway, I mean, so whatever. This is all, I'm not sure. Okay, moving on. So, yeah, so there's also a code in that, but I'm not going to talk about that right now. So here we go. The next thing is, and I watched our police and our firemen. Okay, and I watched our police and our firemen, and we literally have 5 + 4 = 9, 2, which I would, without looking at anything else, I could tell that could be a code of 9, 1, and 1s compressed into 2, so 9-11. And that confirms it. We have 1-9-1 is just a, you know, scramble. They do that too. Just all you need is 19 to just be backwards, and it's really 91. And they can do things backwards, upside down, anytime, any place. Especially with a 1 and a 9, and go backwards or upside down, because they one becomes a stays a 1 and a 9 becomes a 6, or 6 becomes a 9, or just backwards the whole thing. And then we have 158. So 158 can also be 1 + 5 = 68. The 68th day of the year was March 8th, only on leap year. And again, March 8th is really 5-8. It's really the fifth month to the elites. So that's also the tax code of 58, which is the Trump will argue 1 × 58. And then we have 311 here again. 3 + 8 = 11. And this, again, there's more codes when you have three digits, because you can add either or sometimes times them. There's other possibilities. And then this one is the Lester Crowley cipher, and that's 3, 9 + 2 = 11 as well. Okay, this is crazy. It just keeps going and going and going. And then we have this one was, sometimes I forget exactly what these are all saying. This one was 5-7. Okay, I just want to throw an example of where they throw future dates. So they can throw a 5-8 in there, and that's within that timeline. So we're talking about 5, as far as exactly their months and days, 5-1 through 5-11, then 5-13, or in between we have 5-1, 5-4, 5-5, 5-7, 5-8, 5-11, 5-12, 5-13, and that's 5-7. Again, like I've said many times, Trump with thin skin is Mr. 58, and Stinky B.O., the 44th prez, he is number Mr. 57. And I'm going to prove that even more times here and in other videos. Okay, so then the next thing he says is, okay, I watched our police and our firemen, then down at the 7-Eleven. So down at the 7-Eleven is, check it out, it's 5-11. It's 9. 5 + 4 = 9, 11. Because remember, 2 is really 1 and 1. And then we have 8, 11. And then, so 8, 2 + 2 = 1 and 1. And then we have, this one was 8, 11 again. So again, a lot of times the Jewish confirm each other. 7 + 1 = 8 and 2. And then we have this one. We have 7, 11. So 7, 2 + 5 = 7. And then 2 and 2. So now, if these are just by themselves, that would be one thing. And then you can go, okay, they don't necessarily mean that. But when they're all together, and then they're related to all these other words, because he didn't just go somewhere and just say nothing, and then say down at the 7-Eleven, and then you can go, okay, what's the context and everything else? When you put this all in context and how these relate to each other, and what he's really trying to say, and other evidences out there, this is what this means. Okay, I'm just telling you. You don't have to believe me, but I'm just telling you, and you decide. And then down at the World Trade Centers, the next phrase he said, this is all a run-on sentence. So then check this out. Is this a massive coincidence that is 2 plus 9 is 11, so we have 5-11 backwards, 5-11 backwards, 5-11 backwards. And then we have, actually, there's a couple ways of looking at this. 2 plus 9 is 11, and then 9-11 backwards. Or we have 9 plus 9 is 18. I'm not going to do that. We'll just leave it at that. 9-11 backwards. And then I want to show you this as well. Remember the 77 I said earlier? Because I love 7-7 because Stinky B.O. is 7-7 as well as many other things. 1 times 77 and take away the 0 is 7-7. Now, they do these things different ways, but I'm just going to give you that as an example. And then this is when he was born. 8, 2 plus 2 is 4, so that's backwards. 4-8 or 8-4 is August 4th. And so this all has to do with his birth. So this is, his birth is going to, one of his birth, the breaking of the water with the tsunami is going to be 5/11/5/12. But they love the symbol of 5/11 because it's 1 and 1 because it's the twin towers coming down and going from the, you know, the dual system to one world freedom tower. So 5/11/5/11. So this is why it's his birth. So it'd have to do with him being 7/7 and his birth, his fake birth date is 8/4. Okay, next is, right after it came down. So we have a whole long sentence, and each phrase is serious messaging. It's really crazy, okay? We have 5/11 here. We have, this is 9/11, and it's also 5/11. See, this is 1/5 and 1/1. 3 plus 8 is 1/1. So we have the first day of 5/1. This is a mirrored one. 5 is in the middle, and we have 5/1 and then 5/11 on either side. And this is also a version of that, too. We have 5-1 and then 5-2, which is 5-11. Now, you could say, hey, that's not it. But I'm telling you, there's, because we have all this group together, and I know how they do these different things, that's how this works. And take or not, it doesn't matter. So this is 9. So again, 98 is 9 plus 8 is 17. Again, there was 17 states in the first one, and then it was, I will get into that in a little bit here. But then we also have 2 plus 1 is 3, and then we have 9, so we have a 39 or 93 backwards. And then because Trump Lethinsky's saying it, 13 is really, 1 plus 3 is 4, then 1 plus 4 is 5, so we have 45. And that's him. It's referred, so these things will refer to different things based on the different ciphers. And so when you take it all together, it's a whole tapestry of information right here through all these numbers. And what they're trying to say, and I'm showing you the attack days, a birth, there's even a lot more numbers I'm not even showing. There's so many numbers in all these I could show you about a repetition of his birth. 84, 44, we know him as 44. I mean, he's 21, 12, he's 3. I mean, all these different ones that they show many, many times. So I don't show a lot of these other ones that would just keep showing up all the time and making it very repetitive. I'm showing some different ones and some of the same ones to make my point about 5/11 and that this is impossible for this all to be. It's impossible. So here's another one. This is another story. And again, it's a story. I don't know if any of it's true or parts of it are true. We just don't know. We just don't know because everything they say about this story is gematria and lies. And it all adds up to their coding and their narrative and everything and their rituals. It's just really crazy. So we have this, another thing about this is crazy. So we have Times Square, for example. We have pink and purple because the Antichrist is pink and purple, and I showed that in iPad Go 2. And then there's a light-skinned black lady, and Obama's considered that. He's considered black and white in a sense. And then we have pink, and that's very common. This is a very common thing. It's crazy. It has to do with him and his birth. And this is just not a massive coincidence. This is going on right here. You can see that. I mean, maybe you can't, but I'm just telling you. Okay, and then this guy, Steffi Stephanopoulos, I mean, he basically, wow. I mean, that guy's a corrupt dude just with the Clintons and everything for so long. You got to be, if you're going to be with them for any length of time, you got to be a really corrupt dude. I mean, again, both parties are false. They're both playing against each other. It's the chessboard that the elites are playing people against each other. And like all these riots and everything going on, this is all planned. As we've seen, these different characters in this these stories, some knew each other. The guy, the police officer with his knee on a guy's neck, a black guy's neck. I can't think of their names right now. But anyway, they apparently knew each other. And then one was, it's just crazy. I'm not surprised. I mean, that's why this stuff's coming out. Because some people aren't duped at all, okay? So I'm going to get into why this is completely duping people. Again, this was during the The first one I showed you was during Trump administration, and then Trump old thin skin, and then this was during Stinky Bio's administration. So in 2013, I believe. And so I'm going to mention, so you had the backdrop of New York, and this is also a 7-Eleven in New York. But I also want to mention that New York is 666 in simple gematria. I mean, English gematria, or simple gematria is 111. And then I want to mention, too, another thing I just realized recently, and I thought I saw in the past, but another thing that links when the apple falls on iPad Goat and how the apple is the big apple, but it's also Hawaii. And I've shown how there's Hawaii on the upside down and backwards on the apple. Okay, because and how they relate that way, because it's the same apple and same symbolism and Hawaii's on it, and it's a big apple and it's New York and everything. But also another way they relate is pretty staggering, because Hawaii in, so in English gematria is New York 666. In reverse English gematria, where everything's backwards, is Hawaii is equals 666. So that shows you again the birth of the Antichrist, that they would both relate, and that's why there would be an attacks on both coasts or both areas there, and it would start in Hawaii and start in New York, basically, off the coast of New York and off the coast of Hawaii. That's how this would start. It's just crazy. And then look here. Owners charged with hiring illegals is exactly 3 plus 4 is 7. 7 2 is really 7-11. 1 7 1 is 7-11. 8 plus 9 is 17. 1 1 7. 9 plus 8 is 17. 1 1 7. 7-11 backwards. 7-11 backwards. 7-11 mixed up a little bit. And then 7 2 is 7-11. And then we also have 5 plus 2 is 7. And then we have 5, and then we have 2 over here. 7-11 backwards and kind of hidden. And then right here we have 2 plus 9 is 11 plus 7, 7-11. All these are 7-11. Owners charged with hiring illegals. That's how they do this. That's how they hide all this. And it just keeps going. I got so much more. And then look at her name, Rebecca Jarvis. Her name, Rebecca Jarvis, is 116. Upside down and backwards, 116 is 9-11. Again, we're going to bring back 9-11 to this, because ultimately 9-11 is 7-11, is 5-11, is 3-11. They all consider those attack codes, because it's all about going from 2, the 11s, to 1. Okay, like the Twin Towers, going to, from 2, system of 2 to 1. Okay, and then and check this out. This Islip Terrace, you think this is made up? Yes. Or they found the right thing to match perfectly. And then you have a couple of things. You have 45. And we're talking about Trumple as well. Then what? Then you also have 1-7, and they were talking about 17. That was 17 or 8 and 9. So I'm gonna get into that soon. Then we have 7-11, 7-2-2, 1 and 1 is 2. Then we again we have 8 and 9 is 17. So we have 1-1-7, 7-11 backwards. Then we have 1-1, 3 plus 4 is 7. We have 1-1-7. I mean, come on, seriously. How many more ways can you do this? And just the reason why they have this all kinds of ways is just so they could do so many more things and have it more hidden with all these different codes and different ways they do things. But it's how it works. And then check this out. And then they show this 7-Eleven, and her name, she's even talking about it. And look, it's 1088. So 8 plus 8 is 16. So that's 116. And then her name equals 116 in simple gematria. Are you kidding me? That's another massive coincidence. Nope. And this stuff just keeps going. And then they say, yeah, okay, this is a 7-Eleven investigation. And this is where the previous story, it was 17 states. Remember I said in 17 states was 5-Eleven and 7-Eleven, remember? And then this one is 8 states and 9 owners and managers. Remember that phrase of 9, 7-Eleven store owners and managers? And it's like saying 9 is 7, 9, 7-Eleven, 9, 7-Eleven, 9, 7-Eleven, 9, 11 to 7-Eleven. I mean, seriously. So look, so they have 8 states and 9 managers is 17. 8 plus 9 is 17. And then backwards, 17 is 7-1. It's the first day. And then we have 7-11. And that's 7-11. So the first day is 7-1. And then the next birthday is 7-11. And in a sense, the days in between are kind of like birthdays as well. But they really, in different messages, they really focus on 1 and 11. And I think mainly reason, like I said, because they want to go from 2 to 1. So that's why they were focus on the first day, which is 1, and the 11th day, which is 11, which is the 11th day, which is 11. Wow. Which is 2 in a sense. And that's why you'd see a 2 instead of 1 and 1 also, because it represents the two pillars, the two, the good and the evil. And they want to get rid of good, and they just wanted one pillar of evil. One world government, one world religion, one world evil dictator, Stinky B.O. a bunch of BS, Barry Satoru. Okay, here we go. Next. And then I show this clip of the show Stranger Things. And remember, if you watch the show or know it at all, it was set the last season was set in around the 4th of July. So there's a lot of 4th of July stuff going on. Again, 7-Eleven is July 11th, after 4th of July. And we have the whole 4th of July is the fourth day in this whole process. So that's not a massive coincidence. It's part of this. And so they're looking at, and in fact, the Bible says that Babylon will be destroyed or attacked. I think it's even in Zechariah, there's several versions of that, even about Ephraim, which I believe Ephraim's also Babylon. It says that we'll be attacked when they're celebrating. And so that's one of the days I've been looking forward to looking at as far as one of these days being a day of celebration. Okay, so that's another thing. So that's a celebration day, even though it probably won't be the full celebration day because of the, you know, this worldwide epidemic thing going on. So anyway, this fake thing. Anyway, the CV thing. Okay, so this is crazy. So they go in there, they get some drinks, they're thirsty. If you watch the show, you know why. But Hopper, the cop that's undercover kind of, puts down these different things in order. He puts down Funyuns, Coke, Illinois Highway Map, Camels, and those are Slim Jims. I remember all this stuff, except for Illinois Highway Map. I know it was never in Illinois, really. I think I was in one time. But anyways, check this out. If you can believe this, this is all gematria. Okay, ready? Are you ready for this? This is insane. So we have Funyuns, Coke, Illinois Highway Map, in order, it doesn't matter if it's in order or not, really. Camels, Slim Jims is all Jewish ordinal for 5-11. That's a fact, Jack. And that is so off the charts impossible. Again, it's like a combination. If you think of a combination lock with, you know, like let's say there's four rows of numbers, and each number is 0 through 9. Okay. And imagine having 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, all the way out to here, that big of a combination lock. Would anybody ever get into it unless they had a massive quantum computer or something? No. Never would be able to figure it out. It's talking about massively encrypted. We'd never be able to get to it in a million years, pretty much. Even if you did a one combination a day. I mean, seriously, it's I don't know what it is, what that is. It's a 1 to the how many, or sorry, it'd be like 10 to the how many power here. Whatever, it's off the charts. And especially when it has to do with everything I'm talking about in 5-11. It matches exactly. What are the chances of that? Do you see that? Hopefully you do. That's a bam and a half. That is a double bam. This is a massive double bam right here. I'm not sure what to call it. Okay. And then they come outside after this crazy thing. And he's basically kind of taken him prisoner because he's a Russian scientist guy that basically made a wormhole to the upside down and everything through this. They call it the key, which is oh my gosh, there's so many things. The key of David is what's Jesus is going to use to open up the portal to take the remnant home, and they called it the key. So many things. I did an analysis last year of this time, and I'm going to go revisit some of that. 4th and 5th, and there was earthquakes on the 4th, July 4th and 5th, and that has to do with these attacks that are coming on the 4th and 5th. Anyway, there's so much to this, and I had no idea it would be the next year. So, but now, here we go. So this is crazy. Come out here, and then check this out. We have open 24 hours a day. So that is... I forget what I was doing on this exactly. What was the point of this part? I think I was doing 7-8. Yes, 7-8. 1 plus 6 is 7-8, and that's 5-1. So not only do we have 7-11, a lot of the messaging shows 7-11, which is the 11th day. And also, a lot of the messaging shows the first day, which is 5-1. So we have 5-11 and 5-1. This is 5-1. So 1 plus 6 is 7. 7 plus 8 is 15, which is 5-1 backwards. 6 plus 9 is 15, 5-1 backwards. 7 plus 8 is 15, 5-1 backwards. And then we have to take away the 9, or 1 plus 9 is 10, take away the 0. We have 1, 5, 5, 1 backwards. 6, 9, 5, 1 backwards. 7, 8, 5, 1 backwards. And all that stuff. Even this, take away the 9, 7 plus 8 is 5, 1 backwards. And then I want to show this one as well is 1, and then 1 plus 4 is 5. Again, 5, 1 backwards. All these are 5, 1? Please. I mean, give me a break. Okay, and then the next thing here. then Coke Special is right here. So again, what this is basically saying, every time you see an open 24 hours a day, it's telling you 5-1. And like I've shared many times, they don't put these messages right side up. They do them backwards, upside down, or upside down and backwards. And so 15, all over the place, Placer Gematria is backwards, 5-1. Why is 5-1? Because it's the fifth day, the first of a fifth month, first day. And to the elites, the fifth month is July. Or is, to the masses, the fifth month is July. Okay? To the masses, the fifth month is May, but to them, the fifth month is July. To the masses, the fifth month to them is really seventh month. Wow, if that makes sense, I think I've covered that so many times. Somebody own my words here. Okay, anyway, going on here. Then here, another scene here, going on here. And then, of course, we have all this messaging. And if you think about this, I mean, think about all these different locations and all these people seeing all these ads all the time. And they're really Gematria and overall arching. You know, they're all brought together at 7-Eleven, and it's really telling you Destruction Day and all these different things. It's really quite phenomenal and quite stupid and annoying, actually, at the same time. But here, okay, here we go. And then look at this thing. Look at ICE. ICE is several things. It's really crazy. In fact, I remember seeing the footage of when Trump had these, immigration officers going into 7-Elevens, and I didn't grab that slide. But they're ICE. They're ICE officers. And we have ICE going into 7-Eleven. Now, normally that seems normal, ICE and 7-Eleven, but that's all a weird play. You know, you definitely go to 7-Eleven to get ICE, but do you send ICE to 7-Eleven? Immigration officers? So it's a weird play. It's not a coincidence. It's not a coincidence. So what is ICE? There's a couple things. One of the things is, like I've said many times in my last video and other videos, I is also one. Because they look the same. Depending on the font and everything, but they can look exactly the same. Or if you just have a slash, it's one. Or you just have a tower, and it's one. Or it can be an I. So that could be a one. And then C is the third letter of the alphabet, so IC can be four. And then E is the fifth letter of the alphabet, so it could be 45. Well, who's 45? I wonder. But also, who's 45? The 45th president has to do with the end of the end times with this last press. Yes, it does. Also, 4th of July. July is really the fifth month to the elites. So 4th of July would be 4-5. And it would have to do with the 45th president because that's their coding. Get it? 4-5 is 4th of July. The real July is their fifth month, our seventh month in the Gregorian, but their fifth month on the Roman calendar. Okay, that's how it works. It's the revised Roman Empire, and that's the way they look at it. Anyway, so it's 45, and it's also Trump with thin skin, and he's the last prez before Stinky B.O., because it's all about his birthday being Mr. 57, and Trump is 58, because Stinky B.O. is he's going to be, he's 58 right now, and he's going to become the AC of the world before he turns 59, while he's 58. And that's why Trumple is his messenger, because Donald Donald is world ruler, and Trumple is trumpet. And I say Trumple in code because I don't want to say his name, because I don't want to be even more shadow banned than I already am. Okay, here we go. Then we have, then they pull away just this quick shot of the why would it do it quick, except for it says Todd Feather or Todd Father, whatever it is, Todd Fat Hair, no, whatever it is, it's probably Todd Father, or it could be Todd Feather. If you have an idea what it is, I don't know, it's kind of a weird spelling of that, it's not the best way to do that, it doesn't matter. So, TODFTHR in Francis Bacon cipher, and the reason I do Francis Bacon cipher is the only cipher that I know of that has numbers for capital letters as well as small letters. So capital letters in that is 273, and that 2 + 7 = 9. So we have the 9-3 again. Again, I'm going to get into 93 or 9-3 soon, and I'm going to show you what that means. There's so many things going on here. Also, December is the 10th month. Take away the 0, you have 185, which is 113. 311, or it's also 85. A lot of shows and stuff about 85, and even Back to the Future, 1985. 85 is really 58, and again, that's the tactic of 58 with Trumple thin skin. So this was set in this scene, of course, is set in an imaginary 1958, and then we just so happen to have them by ICE which is the Mr. 58 is 45. Trump with thin skin. Okay, I mean, this is all planned. This is all part of it, whether you see it or not. But okay, so there we have that. And then check this out. This will blow your mind. Wander, Indiana, which I guess was a phrase back then, I guess. I'm assuming it was. If you know that for sure, please leave me, you know, comment in the comments about that. Wander, Indiana is 7-Eleven, 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 7-Eleven. Again, this is 7-Eleven backwards. Of course, again, these are going to be backwards because if they're forward, it's a little more obvious. Plus, to add up to 711, you have to have a big phrase, huge phrase to be 7-Eleven on the most ciphers. So you got to do it backwards to hide it also. So check this out. This is really crazy. So 7-Eleven backwards. This is 3 plus 4 is 7. So you have the 2-7, which is 11-7 backwards. Another thing that's crazy about this number is this number plus its reverse is 666. It's one of a couple unique numbers. 234 plus 432 is 666. That's another unique thing about this. Plus it's 711 hidden. And then 11-7. And 3 plus 4 is 7. 11-7. 7, 2 plus, 1 plus 1 is 2, 11. And then I want to show this one as well. This is, again, 144. And so at this time, at 7-11, or whatever day it is, it's 5-11 or 7-11, whatever you want to call it, is the day of the tsunamis. It is the day of the portal. It is the day, I believe, when the 144 leave. And then it's the beginning of the birth of Stinky B.O. Maybe when he starts, maybe the portal's open, maybe he gets inhabited by Lucifer at that first point. I'm not sure exactly. But he's also 144 because he's 1 times 44, which is 44. And in some other ways, he's 144, but he's 1 times 44 because we know him as 44. So one of the ways we know him, he's the 44th press. Okay, and then his opposition in multitudes against his army is the 144,000, okay, in which I'm part of. Anyway, okay, so moving on. And then this commercial here, this 7-Eleven commercial, this boy and this girl, and he's all trying to tell her his name and his Bartholomew Lombardi, and she's going to laugh at it and everything. And then he goes, I'll just tell her my name is Bart. And then she says, oh, I know who you are. You're Bart Lombardi. Bart Lombardi, if you can believe it, in Civil Gematria is 115. So this is not a coincidence. Again, I'm sure I could keep finding 7-Eleven stuff all over the place, and this stuff would just keep popping up because I basically found it in every single thing I found. Every single thing I found. There was not one thing that didn't have 5-Eleven in it anywhere. Okay, and it's not like I search over through 1,000 things and find things that exactly match 5-11. I mean, no. Every single thing I went to that the Lord led me to especially, I mean, there was nothing else that it wasn't. I mean, I just had to look a little bit and I'd find it. I mean, sometimes they're pretty obvious. Sometimes a little more hidden. It didn't matter. Okay, and then here he is biking through this drive-in. Remember the drive-in? Oh, man, those have been... I remember those when I was a kid. And they had the speakers and you pull your car up. I guess those are getting more popular now. They may come back after this viral epidemic we have going on. So anyway, he's going through this drive-in, this old drive-in back in the 80s, and it's called Studio Drive-In. And they just show that, of course, because everything that's spelled is possible gematria, because all words are letters and letters are numbers and they're hidden codes. So Studio Drive-In just happens to be 169, and 6 plus 9 is 15, so that's a hidden 115. And do you see how Studio also is 88, and Drive is 58? That's the attack code, and that's Mr. Trumple, 58. And then 23, CQBO is 23, because when he was in high school, he had a jersey that was 23. I mean, it's phenomenal. Now was in this. Now, then we go to this scene with Marty McFly, and it's in Back to the Future 2, and he sees this Wild Gunman video game, which I think I even played. I mean, it was definitely a real game. And then these kids are playing with it. They turn it on. It says Wild Gunman, and this is a precursor to in Back to the Future 3, where that's how he learned to shoot the gun by playing Wild Gunman. So that's why they link together in Back to the Future 2 and Back to the Future 3. And what's the coding on this? This is crazy. Wild Gunman is 118 in Simple Gematria, and in Jewish Gematria, it's 117. And it just has to be 7-Eleven and the attack code of 118 or 811 backwards, whatever. 118 are the coastal attack codes of New York and Hawaii / the West Coast. and they just happens to keep popping up. It was 118 attack codes on the 11th day, and the 11th and 12th day are the tsunami days. It's crazy, okay? And then we have these boys, and then they're like, and he shoots these things on the arcade game, and then they're like, oh, you gotta use your hand. And then the kid says, that's a baby's toy. That's a baby's toy is 178. 7 plus 8 is 15. 115 is what this is. That's a baby's toy. And it has its reference to 7-Eleven because this is where he starts out. And they're in a Cafe 80s, which is, you know, reminiscent of that. And that's where he learned to shoot at a 7-Eleven. And in fact, here he is shooting in Back to the Future 3. He says, where did you learn to shoot like that? He's like, at 7-Eleven. And so we have, again, a reference to 7-Eleven. And look behind him over here. It says Colt's Patent Firearms. So Colt's Patent Firearms just happens to be, no coincidence. We have, again, that 234 number, which added to its reverse is 666. But we have 3 plus 4 is 7, so 2-7, or it's 11-7. 11-7. Again, how is that 11-7? Again, it's 2 plus 9 is 7. 2 plus 9 is 11, 7's in the middle. So we have 1-1. It's another way of looking at it. We also have 7 plus 9 is 16. We have 216. And that's Stinky B.O.'s number because he was born on August 4th, the 216th day of the year. We also have 9-9. I want to show that as well. There's attack code of Trumple on for 9-9 attached to 58 because it's going to be the Abraham Lincoln, which is 7 plus 2, 72, which is 9. And Trumple is 4 plus 5, 45 is 9, so it's a 99 attack code. And then again, we have 117, 117, 144, like I mentioned before. Oh, it's also 54, backwards is 45. That's another coincidence. No, it's not. And then we have, again, we have 1 plus 6 is 7 plus 4 is 11. We have 7-11 in there as well. We have 1 plus 6 is 7, and then 7 plus 4 is 11. So we have 7-11. 7-11, 7-11, 7-11, 7-11. I mean, are you kidding me? It's crazy. And then how it's attached to 5-11. But this is impossible for this all to work out. Okay, then we have, and I'm going to talk to you about 93 now. So 93, in this particular monument, this is the Flight 93 Memorial. And then there's all these chimes. There's 40 chimes. This is really weird looking. 40 chimes having to do with the 40 lives lost, apparently. There's so much coding in this I'm going to get into right now. And this is a little thing that someone put up with Colorado citizens, and it's about remembering 9-11. These crashed in the field. By the way, they didn't find bodies, and there was the forensics, the body examiner didn't have any bodies, and they just kind of disintegrated. You know, give me a break. It's all a bunch of BS, Barry Satoru. I mean, but I want to show you this. Let's roll. That was a famous quote by one of the passengers that supposedly got these people together, and they were going to fight the terrorists, and that's how it crashed before it got hit its target. And let's roll. Let me just show you how ridiculous this is, the things that we've been told and how false they are, because let's roll equals 11-3, 3-11, and 3-1, and 5-11. So we have 3-11 right here. We have 3-2 is hidden as 1-1, 3-11, 3-1, and we have 5. 3 plus 8 is 11, 11-5, 5-11. So it shows how 5-11 is equal to 3-11. And these are attack codes because this was showing the real attack that's coming. And it proves my theory that more and more that 9-11 was just a precursor to show you what's the real 9-11s that are coming. And the multiple that are coming, including the CV. And I showed you how in the in CV, the full word, the last letter code is 9-11 backwards. Okay, so a little bit of background. 93 has to do with Aleister Crowley and the Order of Thelema. Number 93 is of great significance in Thelema, founded by English author and occultist Aleister Crowley, the biggest highly regarded Satanist ever in the history of the world. And he was Satan's chief of staff back in the 1900s. And he is actually the father of Barbara Bush, and so George Bush and the other Bushes are all grandsons and of Aleister Crowley. Anyway, so she is a daughter of Aleister Crowley, Barbara Bush. Anyway, So then 93 represents do what thou wilt should be the whole of the law. So basically, do whatever you want. It's complete Satanism, which is against God completely, because God doesn't say that. He says do what you should do and do the right things. And there's things you do for love and everything, and things you don't do for love. But the enemy says, no, do whatever you want, because it's all Satanism. And so that's 93. 93 also is a symbol of when people will get the chance to do whatever they want for the most part, as in they're being, you know, told. But no, at some point you will take the mark and you will be completely controlled, and you will have no, you'll be basically hardly be there, and you'll be controlled. And that's where they want to go from 9 to 3. And how I've shared this before, and it's on the dollar bill that shows 1776 in Roman numerals. And they have a way of splitting these pyramids up into three and taking these Roman numerals and splitting up among three pyramids and then spelling it out 777 on top and 666 on the bottom. The bottom is just base human existence. 666 is represented by that, the beast or the base human existence. And all the way up to the top is 777. So on the bottom, you have 666, 6 plus 6 plus 6, because they like to compress numbers. 6 plus 6 plus 6 is 18. 1 plus 8 is 9. So that's the bottom 9 going all the way up to the top. God's number, in fact, Jehovah or whatever. Anyway, God, whatever. I've shown this many times. God's name is 777. It even looks like 7777 or 717 or whatever. But 777 is 7 plus 7 plus 7 is 21. That's why Stinky B.O. is 21 and 12. Because 1 plus 2 is, or 2 plus 1 is 3. And they want to go from 9 to 3. In fact, right here on the Masonic triangle, a lot of people don't know this, on the square and then the compass, the square is a 90 degree. And so that we're pointing to 9, take away the 0. And this is a 60 degree, but it's not a 6 up there because it's 60 degrees from 90 degrees equals 30 degrees. And take away the 0, you have 3. That's what that's showing there. That's another hidden level of that. And it's taken away 60 from 30, from 90, and you get 30, and then there's no zero. So going from 9 to 3, bottom of the pyramid, top of the pyramid. That's what 93 is, the law of Thelema, and all that stuff. Okay, and then check this out. So this just happens to be July 11th on this year, 2020. Just happens to be on the 193rd day. Again, that's where I showed you earlier that 94 is 1 plus 93 is one way to do it. Or 1 times 93 is still 93. So this is on, in a sense, on the 93rd day, because 1 times 93, or if you just have 1 93, or let's say you have 5 93s, or you have 2 93s, or let's say you have 1 93. If you had 1 93, it's just 93. Okay, so 93 is July, and then happens to be on Saturn day. Anyway, I'll get to show you that here in a little bit. So July 11th, also, every year, July 11th marks the day that the world's number one convenience retailer observes its birthday and other companies' milestones. 7-Eleven introduced its iconic frozen carbonated beverage in 1966. And there's a reason for that, too. I'm going to get into that. Okay. I mean, it was an immediate hit. And so they say this is not a coincidence, but they say their birthday, and they can't explain it, but they say it's not a coincidence because it has nothing to do with their name, because one is true and one is not. They call this their birthday, July 11th, but then they say that the reason why they're called 7-Eleven, which is July 11th, the reason why they called 7-Eleven is because they were open from 7 a.m. to 11 at night at one point, and then they went to open to 24 hours at some point. So they say their name is based on, so they're liars completely, because they you can have both. And if you actually believe that their birthday, the day they celebrate that this day, because it's all encoded, it's predictive programming every time they celebrate, because you get a free Slurpee, and I'm going to show you what Slurpee is very soon. That this is a coincidence, that this their name and their birthday are the same number? I don't think so. That's what they want you to believe. Literally, I've looked it up. That's what they say. Okay, so no way. One, they're lying. And they're lying on both, actually, because they just made this name up and they had these things match what they're saying. Because this is why they're doing it, because there's demons behind it, and they've been successful over the years because there's been occultists behind this franchise and much money behind this franchise for many years, because they're in front of so many people in advertisement, in stores, all this programming that's going on behind the scenes in Gematria and everything, and these rituals behind the scenes of these numbers and these words. It's really crazy. But this is part of the world we live in. It's really sick, disgusting, and it's about to completely explode. And I'm thankful to be flying out of here, only to be equipped by Jesus to come back and kick some butt. And that's going to happen. And I have scriptures in my last set of videos about the 5:1 to 5:11 set that talk about that in the Bible, that talk about these different things. So I may put them in the scripture box at some point again, but I don't know if a lot of people look at those. I don't know if a lot of people care to even check it out. Here we go. So happy 7-Eleven day. And that's not coding, is it? Is it? Could it be? Could 7-Eleven day, which is their birthday, they call it 7-Eleven day, could it be coded? Of course it is. 7-Eleven day, just how they spell it too, is 5-6-5 in English gematria. And that's 6 plus 5 is 11. That's 5-11. That's just a coinkydink. And then another thing that's very creepy is because I'm saying this is the year, and 7-Eleven is the year when this stuff starts happening, and that's what they're pointing to and everything. And that's what a lot of my information shows and everything. This just so happened to me. You want to do for the triple boom, the boom that's boom, and hopefully it booms you as much as it boomed me. Ready for the triple boom? Their 93rd birthday is this year on 7-Eleven. They're going to go from 9 to 3 on 7-Eleven. It's crazy. That's not a coincidence. No way is that a massive, over-the-top coincidence. Boom. Okay, here's some more booms. Big Gulp. You know, very iconic drink. Millions of people, I think actually billions of people, billions of consumptions, I should say, from millions of people. That's what I should say. Big Gulp, 115, reverse ordinal. Simple gematria backwards, because they do everything backwards. Not a coincidence. Ready for Slurpee? Remember, it's their 93rd birthday this year, and they love 93, and that's all about Flight 93 and all these 93s, and Aleister Crowley's 93. Slurpee is 93. What is also 93? What things lately in the world are 93? Oh, this thing, that viral epidemic going on, so-called, is 93. Take away the zero. They don't count zeros. And then what I'm saying in the future, the attack on Trump thin skin, exactly spelled out, President Trump's death, 90 is 93 in full reduction. That's just, and there's so many more. I mean, I literally could list 100. I know 193s that are all about this time, what's going on. I mean, our vice president, his full name is equals 93. Jennifer Lopez equals 93, and she was on the halftime show for the Super Bowl, which is Super Bowl 54 or 45. I mean, give me a break. There's so many. It just goes on and on and on and on. Okay, I mean, let me talk about the Shin. Spock, live long and prosper. No. I'm going to live long and prosper, but you aren't very much longer, because this is all satanic and evil. And this guy came up with this through this satanic church, basically the synagogue of Satan, because originally Shin and all this stuff's all godly and everything, but they turned it into evil, corrupt crud. So if you look at this, this is Shin and this is Shin. So this is the double Shin, basically. And see how, okay, remember he's Star Trek. Remember he's Spock. Live long and prosper and all this stuff, right? And then check this out. See these two that they worship? And this is the pentagram. It's right here. And then see how these fingers here, these finger and thumb right here. See how they make the shape of Star Trek symbol right there? See that? And that's in the new, what do you call it? Space Force, Trumple's Thin Skin Space Force. Because they all believe this. Even Trumple. Because when you put these two shins together, you get this. You get the triangle in the shin. And then you basically, what do you get? You get 7 and 7 out of the shin. And I'm going to show you what the shins are separately. But they, by making triangles, they get this. They get the shin. Because you have 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And in the middle one's the 7th. And then we have, check it out. We have 1, 2, and 1, 2. That's 7, 11. It's 7, 11. It's crazy, okay? This is all worship. That's why it's been called 7-Eleven for so long and for so long. And so many things I'm showing. 5-Eleven, 7-Eleven. There's also 5-Eleven. I'm going to show you why is it 5-Eleven. It's also 5-Eleven because we have 5. You have 5 fingers on each hand. That's 5. 5 times, or 55. So we have 7-7. 5-5 is 5 times 11. 5 times 11 is 55, or 5-5. You just show 5 and 5. Another way to look at it is 5 times 11, okay? Then we also have on either hand, that's the shin, and that's why the hand is shaped like that, because that's kind of how the shin is. The shin's got these two kind of butt together, and you got the separate one. And it just so happens to be the 21st letter of the Hebrew alphabet. And then again, 21, Stinky B.O. is 21 and 12, because all his numbers, he's 57, 507 is 12. He's 84 because he's August 4th. 80 plus 4 is 12. And both of those, 1 plus 2 is 3 because he's ultimately 3, going from 9 to 3. And so this is the 21st letter. And then this is made up. There's so much stuff going on with these. It's just crazy. It's very complicated. And then these three are made up of three of these vavs. So this is the shin, and this is the vav. This is the seventh letter of the Hebrew alphabet, the vav. And there's actually three vavs. And if a vav is the sixth letter, and that's the number in a sense for it, even though it's represented by actually a numerical value, but the sixth letter, then that's 666, because it's the sixth letter, sixth letter, sixth letter, sixth letter, okay? So that's another way of looking at it. So we know that these are vav, vav, vav. And we know about, some of us know about some of that, and hidden things with 666. So that's also when you flash that every single time, he's basically saying 666, 666. And you put these together and they make two sevens. Okay, this is just crazy. Hopefully you're following this. And then what are the vavs? Look at the, remember I said vav, vav, vav? Look at two vavs right here in Monster Energy Drink. We have vav, vav, vav. That's a vav, vav, vav. That's 666 because it's the sixth letter. That's a vav. It's just a little distorted. And then that's Monster. And guess who's the real Monster? Because guess who signs their name with an, see the Monster, the O in Monster with a line through it? Who signs their name with an O with a line through it? Stinky B.O. He's the real Monster. He's the 666. You'll see. And that's why I have over 470 solid reason why he's the Antichrist. And this is probably like 473 or 4. I don't know. One of those two. I'm kind of mentally keeping note all this time. So anyway, look at that. He's the Monster in the energy drink. Anyway, it's crazy. Okay, more. So another interesting, there's so many interesting things about 7-Eleven. So 7 is even and L even. So S and L. Oh, by the way, if you're watching Saturday Night Live, it's S and L. And that's the same thing. It's Shaddai, El Shaddai. Okay, so, but it's more than that. On their side, it's worse. So 7-Eleven or 7 times 11 is 7-7. Okay, in Hebrew, S is Shin. And L is God. So we know L is God in several ways. Okay, L is God. Shin means Almighty and L means God. So together, Shin and L is Almighty God. So 7-Eleven means Almighty God, or in Hebrew, El Shaddai. Okay, so however, they've completely perverted this whole thing, the synagogue of Satan. So what they do is they use it similar, but then when you add them, it's different. So when two hands are employed, it's Saturn Shaddai, because they're really worshiping Saturn. And this is really Saturn. Right in where the hands are, this is Saturn. I'm going to show you how this is Saturn. This is a hexagon, and then this is the star of Molech. It's what I should have said. This is the star of Molech. But inside the star of Molech is the hexagon. Some people think of Star of David. So the star of Molech is worship, Molech worship and Saturn worship, ultimately. And, you know, that's what it is. So two hands are employed if it's Saturn Shaddai or Saturn Almighty, because they worship the dark sun and many other names it has. And here's in a temple here showing that as well here, an older temple in Jewish, with Jewish, Hebrew writing and everything. And Satan is Saturn, or Saturn, Saturday. Okay, get it? Saturday? Okay, now, this is crazy. So how is this Saturn? Well, this is this hexagon inside the star of Molech, and the hexagon is really a flattened cube. So if you take this hexagon, you draw a line here, line here, line here. It's a 3D flat, but it was a cube, but it's flattened now. If you just look at a cube, and from an angle, and just squint your eyes, it looks like it's a hexagon, basically. So it's a flattened cube. They worship the cube. They worship Saturn. And how is that? Well, Saturn is a hexagon. And the Cassini probe was sent out by JPL. It used to be Jack Parsons Laboratories. Jack Parsons was a massive Satanist. And now it's JPL, is Jet Propulsion Laboratories, works with NASA and everything. The Cassini probe was out for years and years. It took it years to get there, apparently. And I believe it actually got there because they have all these scans of it, and they've brought back all kinds of information, and they believe they found that there's inside there. And again, this is from their white papers. This is from expert Anthony Patch and his work. He does a phenomenal job, and he knows this stuff left and right, backwards, forwards. As far as this particular subject about Saturn and the Cassini probe, I've gotten a lot of information from Anthony Patch. And so they sent the Cassini probe, and it went around Saturn for years and scanned it and stuff. And they found that they already worship this thing from demons that are in them, but then they've proven that there's a cube in there, and it's made of metallic hydrogen, they call it. Metallic hydrogen, whatever. And that's the symbol of the cube, which is a flattened cube on top of Saturn. So that's what they're worshiping. And again, another thing about that is they believe that the demons are locked in there. It's a prison, and it's got... it's that ring around Saturn is like a lock, and they're going to use CERN, and that's why they crashed the Cassini probe on Saturn to get the coordinates of exactly where it is, so they can lock in those coordinates from CERN, and then they could do this whole thing, rip the space-time fabric, and then basically beam through a portal through the abyss, beam these things from Saturn up through the ground of Earth, in a sense coming from underneath the ground or something. I don't know. That's what they believe, and so... And I heard this from Anthony Page. I'm like, whoa, that's crazy. And it fits a lot of things. I mean, I don't know ultimately what it is and what's going on, but I know these things are going to come through. It's in Revelation 9. And it looks like, and I'm going to show here an iPad goat soon, and even at the end of this, how it shows an iPad goat as well coming up, and with Osama bin Laden raising his hands and everything. And then check this out. Like I said, remember 93 was going from 9 to 3, July 11th, and then that's on Saturday this year. Saturn Day. It's just a coincidence, just a big quinky dink, no big deal. And that's supposed to be the day of the portal. Okay, and that's what we're talking about. That's what I'm talking about. Okay, believe it or not. Okay, and then another thing about seven, even, and even, is they're both even. And even, when even has come, even has to do with judgment. Because if, for example, think of the judgment scales. When they're even, justice is served. When they're out of balance, it's an injustice. So it's basically saying, promoting 7-Eleven another way, they're saying Almighty Saturn's judgment. Because they're going to cause these things that are going to happen. Now, of course, God is allowing it, but he's not doing it. That's very important. A lot of things God does not allow, or certain things that he lets happen, but certain things he can't have. Anyway, I'm not getting all that about free will and everything, but what he does, though, is he allows us, but they're causing the destruction on 7/11/7/12, or whatever day that is, 11 and 12, and I'm deducing that these tsunamis are going to be 7/11 and 7/12, okay, because it's about judgment, or evening the scales of judgment. That's what I'm saying. Seven, S even, L even is, their version of Almighty Saturn's judgment. Again, it's a perversion of God's ultimate judgment. And in a sense, they're really doing it for him, in a sense, because people are going to the end of their belief, which is evil and destruction and all that. But anyway, okay. And I'm going to get into a little bit more about 7-Eleven. So 7-Eleven started as Southland Ice Company. And there's one of their first stores right there. And then Southland Ice Company just happens to be 9/11. Okay, 9/9/2 is 9/11. It's also 5/11. 2 + 9 = 11. 5/11 again, because 2 is 1 and 1. And then 1/1, 1 + 4 is 5/11. And that's all massive coincidence too, right? All these things all together, all these things that add up to 5/11, and all this stuff is all coincidence. Nope. Okay, and then let me show you more. So Southland Ice just happens, and that's what's shown on a lot of those. With Southland Ice, as they're known as for a long time, 193. Remember, that's exact day. 193rd day is July 11th, only in a leap year. And then 131 is 311. And then what's this right here? We have 1 + 6 is 7. 9 + 2 is 11. We have 7-Eleven. So Southland Corporation is 7-Eleven. And even look at Southland right here. That in itself, because it shows both words, that in itself is 7-Eleven. How is that possible? Because demons are all behind this. They are doing this. They're finding all these ways to do this hidden so they can promote their agenda through, this predictive programming, this subconscious It's called Lesser Magic. They use this kind of lesser magic to promote their agendas, their rituals, and move the masses forward to their ultimate goal, which is one world government, one world religion, one world dictator. And they say, "Oh, thank heaven for 7-Eleven," because they want the people that are holding back the restrainer to leave. Okay, that's what that means, I'm telling you, but I think that's what the Lord told me. So, and then after that, after Southland Ice, they were called Totem, because you're toting things, Totem Store. This would be a Totem Store, and it used to be called See Southland Ice Co. Totem Store is 720, 7, 1 plus 1 is 2, 7-Eleven. Are you kidding me? This is creepy. This is super creepy. This guy, Daniel Patrick McCurdy Sr., okay, he's a guy that wrote, he's credited mainly with writing, "Oh, thank heaven for 7-Eleven." If he really did, he was completely, you know, demonically inspired, but I doubt he even did. He was just a guy that he used probably because his name and everything matched, and his birthday and everything matched. Now, check this out. This is creepy. So, this is his name. His date of birth was November 25th. November is 11. 2 plus 5 is 7. 11, 7. And then his year is 1. 1 plus 9 is 10. Take away the 0. 1, 5. 4 plus 1 is 5. 5, 1 is the first day. Remember, 5, 1 is the first day. And then 7, 11 or 5. See, you have the 5 and the 2 right here. So 7-Eleven is made up of 2 and 5 because it's 2 more than 5-Eleven. It's really crazy that what's in here. So you have 5-Eleven, 2 plus more is 7-Eleven, and then you have 5-1 right here. It's all right here, 5-1 to 5-Eleven, which is hidden 7-Eleven, or 7-Eleven is hidden 5-Eleven. It's right here. And then check this out. This is the day he died, which it was really a ritual killing. I guarantee it. February 5th. February is the second month to them. To the world, right? 2, 5 is 7, and 2 plus 1 plus 8 is 11. 7-Eleven. Okay, if that doesn't creep you out, I don't know what else will. And then there's more. I have more. And again, remember I showed you how, "Oh, thank heaven for 7-Eleven" was gematria for 5-Eleven. So was "Oh, thank heaven 7-Eleven," which they've used both many times. Check this out. Daniel Patrick McCurdy is 93. Are you kidding me? And then that's not even it. Wait till you see this. From the day he was killed, murdered really, to July 11th, 2020 is 888 days. Now that's a massive off the charts coincidence. Nope, because it's about the transition to the portal, about the 88 or the 888, and so is Donald J. Trump is 888. And then check this out. Backwards, it's 7. Remember I said about this double shin? It's 2 plus 5 is 7, 7, 7. It's also 7, 2 plus 9 is 11. It's 7, 11 backwards. That is also possible? Nope. Okay, check this out. I look into his background a little bit, and I didn't do too much. I'm sure if I could look into it, I'd find a lot more. Because right away, I mean, I literally don't look very far with all these things as I dive into them and I see this stuff going on. And it just bam, bam, bam. This is crazy. So this guy had an outstanding career. This is on his obituary. He was a top 40 radio icon. And then he was in the Charlie and Harrigan show in Dallas or whatever it was on the mighty 1190 radio channel, right? The mighty 11. And meanwhile, like 9-11, that was obvious. That's also Trumple's number, 11-9, because that's when he was elected, or that's when the election was going on. And that's who he was actually technically elected. There was 11-9. The 11-8 was the election, but he was actually elected the next, late that night, the next day. And then check this out. So we have 9-11 backwards. And what's the mighty? The mighty is 11-5, 5-11 backwards. Boom. No way. Okay, going on here. So I'm almost done here. I want to go through a couple things, and I'm going to get into more stuff in my next videos. Mind-blowing stuff the Lord's been downloading to me. And I think this is some of my biggest downloads I've gotten. Again, I have a full solve. I don't know if I mentioned it yet, but I have a full solve, incredible solve that supports all the things I've been saying of the Economist Magazine 2020. You won't believe it. And that's going to take several days for me to put that together on video. It's phenomenal what the Lord has shown me. Your jaw will drop. My jaw dropped and hit the floor and bounced back up and hit the floor and bounced back up several times. And I was like, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, it was just insane. I mean, I'm sorry, but So well, this is why I see the timeline now. Now I believe I have the timeline right with the months and then the apple falling at the right time. And I'm going to explain this for a second. Okay, so we have, because this is yin and yang right here, that's represented by China, yin and yang. Okay, so that, and the Chinese New Year started in January this year. This also, again, represents 2017, 2018, 2019, and then I think 2020 in different ways. I think it's different constructions of these forms. And I've shared that before. The back row, front to the back row, it was, this is August 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, and 2017. That was the eclipse in August 2017. Then we had 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, but this year is January, February, March, April, May, June. So it doesn't go June over here. It goes June right here. Why? Because Stinky B.O., this is Stinky B.O. right here. And why? Because Trumple in March, March 11th / March 13th, did an emergency and put everybody in lockdown. And I believe that's what this barbed wire is. Because we had China, I mean, this yin and yang right here in January was in lockdown. And then we didn't experience until March. Right here, see the barbed wire? And then I think it's going to get worse this month, the month of June, because you have extra barbed wire. It's through Trump. Z has control, in a sense. And it's through here. It's going back here. And it's a little bit less back here in the May. It's like one barbed wire that's going in front. It's not as bad. And then right June, you got a lot more. This is the sixth month. And another reason why I believe that as well, and it's not back here, is because this month is 6 months. And this is Stinky B.O. This is him with the ear, with the ultraviolet on him, and I've showed that many times, how he's ultraviolet, but his leg is in this right here. See, his leg is in here, and this is the eclipse in June, okay, in June 20th in the United States, but June 21st, it's going to be over in the, you know, the other hemisphere of the world, or whatever, or however you look at that, basically. But this is the year, this is the month of that, June. And his leg is in here. No other leg's in here. This one isn't back here. Whatever. So this is June. And he's going to be doing another commencement speech on 6-6, June 6th. That shows, and this is announcing his birth. And this is the birth. It's going to be an annular eclipse. That's what this gold ring is. It's an annular eclipse at that time. And then it's going to be before the birth. And the birth is in July. So June, she's like the little slash, but this is July, and this July is melting into this right here. See, July is right there. This is July, and then behind July is the rabbit. And now I understand, for some, I didn't really look at it before, but someone mentioned it, and then this is rabbits are called bucks. Just like bucks and does, just like deer are. And this is a... From here, I knew this was a buck moon, but it was on the wrong, and this is just sharing that this is a buck moon. See how this head perfectly round from the front, but on the side, I mean, you see all these are not perfectly round, but the way he's tilted his head down, it looks perfectly round. It looks like a moon, and this is a buck coming out. So this is actually what it's kind of giving you a hint of over here. This is a buck rabbit, or a buck bunny. Maybe that's how they got Bugs Bunny. Buck Bunny. I don't know. Bugs Bunny. A buck bunny right here, and this is July, and so this is the buck moon in July, because July is called the buck moon, and this is a buck rabbit, okay, all right, that's July, August, September, October, November, December is what I got so far, because there's another eclipse in December, and there's an eclipse right there. That's crazy. So this is the order, I believe, and then again, right here, he starts out by doing the commencement in June. And then the apple, because this is still touching this, and it's right touching her. This head's touching her. This is touch going into this. This is the next one. And this is when the birth, this is when it falls. So she's kind of in between these two. So it's really in July, and that's when the apple falls. And then we have the 13-day process, the 11 days of the apple rolling, splitting, or 10 days of apple rolling, splitting on the 11th day, then the flower blooming on the 13th day and all that. So it's crazy. Really nuts what I'm getting right now. It's phenomenal. I think we're... could be finally there. It's amazing. Okay, here we go. Then I just want to say this real quick, because like I mentioned, he's speaking on 6-6 because he's 6-6. I've said that many times. He is 6-6 or 6-66 and 666. Stinky B.O. is. Okay, and I've proven it many times. And then also mentioned that he's Mr. 57. I've shown many times how he's 57. I'm adding one. I'm going to add another one right now. He said, I've now been, when he was campaigning, I've now been to 57 states. I think one left to go. This is really coded right here. So that's why, another reason why he's 57, because he said 57 states. When we know that's not 57 states, people think he gaffed. It's like Trump gaffed when he said 7-Eleven. No, this is all planned. But oh, he made a mistake. No, these people don't make mistakes like that. Not in public. They're demonically inspired. They say things by code for reasons. So it's 57 with one more to go, and that makes Mr. 58, and that's Mr. 58 Trump with thin skin. I think with one left to go, you add one more to 57, you get 58, and he is 57, Trump is 58, and right here you have 57, he's Mr. 57, and why? Because he's speaking on 6-6, but guess what? Before that, he spoke at a commencement on 5-16. 5-16 is 5, 1 plus 6 is 7. He's Mr. 5-7. And then one more to go is right here, is right next to him. Trumple Thinskin is right here. This is how he sits with his tip of the spear hands, the Illuminati triangle going down. There's his hair, everything is right here. In fact, from this angle, when you see Lily from this angle over here, looking at this wall, the buck is coming out of his head. And that is has to do with, I think it's Celtic New Year or something, or Celtic, the buck, or the, I forget what it is, but it's, J.K. Bugout mentioned it years ago, about a year ago, or a couple years ago maybe, and it ends up starting or ending on January 20th, and that's the inauguration of Trump. So it's showing his inauguration right there. Okay, so then I'm also showing how this coming down is, I think it's not only a sperm, but it's, I mean, people think it's sweat, but it's sperm, because it has to do with, and there's a phallic symbol over here, and it's shooting up right here. But also, this may be a meteorite, because I've shown in the floor there's a meteorite. In fact, on the fourth day of my last possible dates, it was on 11 or 5, 22 was on the fourth. There was a fireball that went over Australia, and that was on the fourth day. It's crazy, okay? And this might be representing a meteor coming through in a sense. But it's also, I believe, it's because this is upside down J, it's possibly July. And then V is 22, 22nd letter of the alphabet. 2 plus 2 is 4. V is also, in Roman numerals, is 5. So I think this might be saying July 4th and 5th. And I have confirmation of July 4th and 5th from a few things. The full moon, that's going to be July 4th and 5th, depending on where you're at in the world. I found it on the floor. It looked like it was V and upside down V and slightly in an A. So V is 4, 2 plus 2, and an A is one more. So anyway, I usually have multiple reasons for one thing. I don't just go, oh, hey, that looks like something, and that's it. I usually have to have multiple reasons to back it up for why I believe something is. This is just probably the fifth version of this. And then here we go, Osama bin Laden character, right? But this is when the abyss opens. This is when the attack. He's on an iceberg, which is striking this little island of ice, which is in the shape of Hawaii, like I've showed many times. And I can show again right now. And that's when Hawaii gets struck, is on the 11th of whatever month it is. It's going to be on the 11th. I guarantee it. Okay. And it may be this time frame. Very looking like it's very hugely, massively possible. Okay. And then we also have July. This is a serpent sting, which, because out of the abyss will come serpent, this is a scorpion tail. Out of the abyss will come these locusts, and this looks like a locust head right here. See that eye and the mandibles right here, and then, but also right here is a scorpion tail. Also in the scorpion tail, I've mentioned before many times, this is a dark baby and this is a light baby because it's a twin birth. It's a dark baby coming down because Lucifer's coming down, and it's a light baby going up. And that's the man-child right here. This is all hidden in here. I've shared this before. This is insane. And then also I've showed in the Economist magazine how when you take the Economist magazine normal way and then you turn it backwards and put it right at the spine, there's also all kind of animals and imagery. And this happens to be a locust. This is a locust coming out of the pit. See the eyes right here and the double mandibles, or maybe even triple mandibles. But then if you look at the really faint lines, it's legs here. It's this locust coming out of the pit right here. And that's in the Economist magazine. When you take the cover and then reverse the cover and then put them side by side at the spine. And I've showed that the next 9/11 series, part one You can check that out if you want. And you can see all these different crazy faces and creatures in this, all this stuff. You can maybe see some right now. There's a snake right up here. Some different animals. There's a creature right there. Anyway, so this is phenomenal. And then, so I'm going to show you this as well. So in his turban right here, because I know this is the time of the 11. And so I'm like, maybe there's July in here. And it looks like I see J upside down right here. Let me go back. Looks like I see J. This is a J. And these two are 11. J11. And I also think I see it in his turban. It's big 7. See that 7? You see that massive 7 here? 7. And then this is crazy because it also is a 3. See this line right here? It goes like this. It's a 3. Or it's a sideways M. And then we have 1-1. So it's 7-1-1. Or 7 is also 3-11. So this, I believe this is showing 7-11 and 3-11. And this 3 right here reminded me of a sideways M. Just like on the movie 300 I did a few videos ago. Where, and I forgot to mention this. I totally forgot to mention this. It's crazy. Because this is a 3 sideways. But it's really, if you look sideways, it's an M. It's more of an M than a 3. But so the third month is the fifth month because M is May. So third month is the fifth month. Fifth month is the third month. And you, of course, they'd like to take away the zeros, like I said. Then we have two slashes right here. Two slashes. So that's 3-11 or M-11. As in May or the fifth month, 5-11. And this is 7 or this is an M right here. I'm going to highlight this more at some point. You can see it, but it looks like an M right here. That's 3 and 11, or 7, 3, 11. So it's showing 7 is 3, 7, 11, and 3, 11 is what I think that's showing. That's really crazy. And that's when the pit opens. That's when the attack on Hawaii happens, because it's the cap to the abyss where they're going to open the portal right there. So, and then also, I'm going to be doing a massive decode of this. It's really phenomenal. There's some crazy messages in here. Let me give you one example real quick just so you give you a little bit of a taster on this. You have Trump, and then it just shows the beginning of Brexit right here. So you have Trump. It's an eye chart. It looks like an eye chart. Trump, and then BR, exit, and it keeps going down here, and there's words smashed together, right? And down here you see vision in red, and I'm going to talk about what that is. So check this out. It talks about in 2020 Trump's exit because of Kim and Yo, and I'm not going to get into all that right now. So who is Kim Yo? Look it up, maybe. Kim Yo. Who's Kim? Who's Yo? Who's Kim Yo? Anyway, so, and I'm going to get into some of this stuff. There's so many things about war in this, and even dates this 3-11, 5-11, and 7-11 in this whole cover, and it confirms everything I've said, and it's phenomenal what I get into, what the Lord showed me, the way he delayered all this stuff. So I'm really excited to show this to you. And then I just want to thank you. I want to thank all of you who've given. If I haven't had a chance to thank you, because I sometimes get little donations and I can't get to them. I just can't. I've got too many things going on and I can barely make these videos. But I give that opportunity to thank you who prays for me and my family. If you pray, please pray for me and my family. We're always getting attacked by YouTube in many different ways. They almost threatened to take away my channel because I had a couple things that were false, and then they went backwards on it, and they said, "Oh no, this is not no, you this is not we made a mistake." Literally, I'm not getting to all that. I mean, I thought I'm done, and I will never make a video again. And then they basically backed it off, and I was so shocked. And I think it's because of your prayers, because I want to reach more people, and it's about me reaching people before this stuff happens. So, anyway. Thank you for your prayers, and I thought this was done. I thought this was all done, and it's not about, I don't care about being done. It's about reaching more people. I got to reach more people. I've reached over 500,000 different people with this message, and it might be, according to my numbers and things I've seen, it might be 550, almost approaching 600,000 people now, different people. So it's just amazing, and I need to keep going, even though sometimes I don't want to. And it was really difficult after this last time because I just begged Lord to kind of take it from me. And he just said one more time. And I thought he meant that about the last time, but he made it super clear that this is the last time. So if this doesn't happen, or I don't want to do this anymore, I feel like he's let me go. And so I'm just letting you know that. I don't know why I wasn't going to say that, but anyway, I feel like this is the last time, whether it's going to be it or not. It's just so much. But we have a month and a half, basically. Now we have 43 days till 7-Eleven. And some stuff happening before that, so about 40 days or less. I don't know. Whatever it is. So thank you for your help. And then I just also want to ask for any support. My family is always needing stuff. I'm not able to work because of what the Lord's showing me, what he needs me to do. It's also crazy with this whole the viral epidemic going on and everything. I can't imagine I'm going to be able to fit in this whole thing anyway. And the Lord wants me in this time, short time we have left, whatever it is, to get this stuff out. It's just he keeps impressing upon me. And I keep asking him, do you want me to do this? I can find something and whatever. And he's like, no, I don't want you to do that. You've got to do this. The time you have short. Time you have a short. He's confirmed by so many downloads. So many crazy things I'm seeing. Just wait till I get some of this stuff out, more of this stuff. Hope this kind of blessed you and show you some things. But, man, I'm just totally blown away by what's going on right now and the craziness in this world. And if you don't know Jesus, you need to. He's the one that's giving me all this information. And I'm just doing my best to try and piece it together. He doesn't tell me the dates or anything. He just gives me information, and then I don't know what he's trying to say. I'm trying to figure it out. And he's just giving me breadcrumbs on the trail. That's all I can do. And if you don't understand that, then go somewhere else, please. I don't need to deal with it. And so I'm asking everybody as well, if you have any, and this is, I'm going to make this super clear, please. If you don't have information on, I need information if you're able to find and glean things from different sources about July 1st through July 13th. That's it. That's all I'm taking as far as if you're saying, oh, 2021 or this thing, time, this time, that time, I'm just going to delete them. I'm just telling you, I don't need to wade through all that stuff. If you, as far as suggestions on time frames and stuff, now, if you want to just make general comments and everything, normally fine. But if you're talking about time frames, I'm going to get rid of them. I'm not interested. I'm not interested in people preaching on different things as well. That goes on all the time. You have no, man, it's crazy. So, I just want to get to the information the Lord's showing me. And if you can help me with that, if you throw in a bunch of extra stuff that's just making it harder for me to weed through, it's difficult. So anything you can help, if you find things, see things from now till then, put them on comments of this video or my next videos, any one of them from this one on, give me information, find whatever you can that supports this time frame, or don't, either way, or whatever. But if you're able to, then do that. If you like doing that, do that. It will help me. I can sift through more things that way and see more things, even though I have a lot of stuff to get out right now. It's crazy. If I can add the amazing boom here, there that you find for me, it's awesome. It just supports and helps breakthroughs for people that normally don't see any of this stuff. And then thank you for, if you're able to give, I my family needs it right now. I really need it right now. I'm a couple days from my rent. I've had some gifts, but it's just not going to be enough. And I'm overdue on my phone bill and everything. I have just a little bit more time to pay that. I don't know how long the company, I'm not going to say who it is, per se, will let me do it without paying. I deferred it a little bit, and hopefully it just gets taken care of very soon. So I'm just at a faith walk here. So if you're able to support, I appreciate it. And I'll have a PayPal link in the description box. If you're able to give it all, I thank you so much. My family thanks you from the bottom of our hearts. And we thank everyone who's given, whether financially or, you know, by prayer or comments or sharing these videos. And again, just getting to as many people as possible before this happens, so the Lord can work in their hearts and show them this stuff is coming. And this stuff's just around the corner. It's literally just around the corner. It's just crazy. So thank you so much if you're able to give. And God bless you, whatever. And please come to Jesus while the coming is still available. Because without him, we have no chance. What's coming? How can you have any kind of hope in mankind? How can you have any kind of hope in this world with all this stuff keep coming down? It's just getting worse, and it's labor pains, and they're just going to get more intense and more frequent before the baby's born, and that's the man-child born into heaven and the Antichrist born here, and that's Stinky B.O. So this is Exalted Lamb 1 over and out.